good to go. Okay. All right, everybody. Sorry about the technical difficulties. We finally have everything set up underway. Welcome to another beautiful night for NISA action. My name is Max Ballpuff, and on behalf of all of us here at the Maryland Bobcats FC, we thank you for making us part of your Saturday night entertainment. Tonight's contest between Maryland Bobcats versus Savannah Clovers will be the second of the three meetings between the two sides so far this season, as we're just about set to get underway. A lot of changes for the Savannah Clovers entering today's contest. They are coming in with a new starting goalie compared to last time they were out here. Jack Crichton, number 25 for Savannah, will be their starter from Doncaster, England, which is way north of London, if you've ever been to the United Kingdom. He'll be between the pipes, and it's an odd formation, more of a foosball-style formation. Daniel De Leon and Ford Hunt are the only two listed defenders for Savannah today. It looks like they might drop a couple of midfielders or forwards into those positions as the game goes along. Listed midfielders, Zach Hargreaves, the team captain, Aaron Martinez, and Cameron Schneider. And at forward, Joel Bunting, Mason Moyers, Max Rugova, and Chandler Vaughn, along with Alex Woods. Savannah will be starting with the ball through the first part of today's contest, as they'll be moving from left to right, and the Bobcats will be moving from right to left. We'll tell you about their starting lineups in a moment once the game gets underway. Our referee in the center is Brian Albert. He'll be assisted on the lines by Trevor Hadlick, Douglas Clayton, and our fourth official today calling for substitutions and stoppage time is Jose Zepeda Aguilera. Ball is off. Let's have a little fun here from the Maryland Soccerplex. Starting today for Maryland Bobcats, coached by Alex Cow, as Savannah swings it back around for Daniel De Leon. At forward will be Darwin Espinal, Sam Solomon, Abdu Yam, and Malik Tom. At midfield, Michael Akinkoye, Manuel Gonzalez, and Josilin Pusayan, the team captain. And on defense, it'll be a back three of Philip Burnett, James Feilerman, and Richard Forca. And in net will be Alex Sutton, the main starter on this season, as Forca gets a sharp elbow here, as Maryland unable to win the ball off of Akinkoye. Files instead for Cameron Schneider. Finding the waiting feet of Martinez, and Savannah didn't like any of their options, so they'll head backward through De Leon. It should be noted, Savannah's entering today's game on an 8-game losing streak. They have had no points since a 1-1 draw May the 6th against Chattanooga, and their most recent game was a 5-0 drubbing at the hands of the Table Toppers. This ball comes in, and Richard Forca backheels it away off his off foot. Bunting, able to find a waiting pass, finds Cameron Schneider. Savannah pressing early here in the first minute of action. Espinal gives a run down to Hargreaves and forces a bad pass here as Moyers harassed all the way through. They go back to De Leon. Hargreaves, hand goes up from Rugova, unable to connect with him, as Schneider gets it back for De Leon. Now Hargreaves again. Hargreaves has two men surrounding him, and Forca wins the ball allegedly unfairly against Alex Woods. So a free kick at the edge of the middle third for Savannah will set up their offensive attack as Sutton commands the presence at the back line. Hargreaves stands over it and waits for everybody to get going. Rugova, noticeable in his long hair and white headband, will make a run into the middle of the box. Ball goes behind him. Header comes through. It got behind Rugova and will go out of play for a throw-in. Backup goaltender tonight for Maryland will be John Hollinger. This is one of the few times he's made it into the roster for a game. The normal backup, Sylvanus Eku-Thompson, is not listed today. And the backup today for Savannah is Jack Pondy, should we need him. Maryland now moves it into the offensive third for their first time, as the first touch from Jack Crichton is a long boot to the midfield line. Crichton has a very interesting history, as well as does his father, and I'll tell you about that as today's game goes along. Here's Rugova's first touch. Long pass comes in. Forca points it for Sutton, who will scoop it with his right hand and up into the chest for a throw. Able to find. Runner for Espinal. Feilerman making a run through to the offensive side. He'll pull up now as Yam has it in the middle of the field. Akinkoye for Feilerman. Feilerman ably patrolling that left side line. Goes for Forca, who's able to find Pusayan playing in the central defense role in today's contest. 1-on-2, and somehow the Bobcats are able to keep control and get around both defenders. Entering into the box is Malik Tom, and unable to get it through, it'll be a Bobcats corner 3.5 minutes into the contest. So a little bit about Jack Crichton. He's a midseason signing for Savannah. Jack's dad, Paul, had a 25-year professional career as also a goaltender before getting into coaching. Paul played the plurality of his career in England, bouncing up and down the pyramid with Nottingham Forest, Doncaster Rovers, Grimsby Town, West Bromwich Albion, Burnley, and his last matches with Cambridge United. He's probably most recently known for Sheffield United because he made the FIFA video games with that. Header comes through, and Bunting pokes it up away. Feilerman's bid goes well wide and over the fence, and that's going to be a long run for those ball kids. Someone's got to get it. So Paul Crichton is currently the goalkeeping coach for the Orlando Pride of the National Women's Soccer League. He has a NWSL championship from his time as the goalkeeping coach with the nearby Washington Spirit from 2019, prior to the pandemic. Crichton's boot is intercepted by Feilerman, who pokes it long. Savannah is content to play this on a throw-in. De Leon waits and finds Schneider to take the throw-in instead. Tosses it in. And the pink boots of Joel Bunting cannot corral that one. They'll help it falls for Espinal, surrounded by three men. Falls for Gonzalez, who finds Feilerman. Feilerman able to keep his balance after stepping on the feet of Alex Woods and gets the ball for Alex Sutton. Maryland's goalkeeper finds a streaking Feilerman down the side, and Feilerman went up to get it like he was trying to rob a home run over the wall in a baseball game. Either way, it falls for Savannah to have possession. Bunting was turned around and was unable to find that ball. Hargreaves back instead for Ford Hunt. Hunt waiting for options to develop. Martinez. Moyer's back for Hunt. The two natural defenders seem like they're taking apart the central back role. Long ball comes in over and behind Philip Burnett. Rogova's got it. Cannot get around Burnett. Burnett was a critical part of Maryland's draw against Chattanooga in the last game here at Maureen Hendricks Field. Both of these teams are coming in off of losses. Maryland coming in off of a loss to Flower City Union, their first to them this season, in a 2-0 loss up in Rochester. And as aforementioned, Savannah coming in on a 5-0 drubbing at the hands of Chattanooga, as they just continue to pile up points and look to be securing that first spot in the table. They will have 5 games in the month of September, 4 of which are on the road, so that is about as close to a test as Chattanooga has had so far in the schedule this season. De Leon, and he mistimes the pass, thought Schneider was going to stay back on it. Schneider instead went forward. It'll be a conceded throw-in, and Schneider is not going to hand the ball to Espinal and make his job any easier. Leaves it instead for Feilerman, one-time Detroit City teammate of Darwin Espinal. Back for Feilerman, and Sam Solomon is unable to run that one down, so it'll fall instead for Savannah's back line. Sam Solomon, on this season, mostly used in a substitute role, as this is just his second start. Sutton has it in his penalty area, finds Poussaint in the center role. Akinkoye for Feilerman. Akinkoye, as Maryland is going backward with it, Forca finds Poussaint. Maryland's captain has some space in the middle of the field, opts to take it, finding Burnett on the wing. We played just under 8 minutes so far in this contest. No shots on goal for either club. In for Yam. Duyam and Malik Tom had 2 incredible goals back-to-back to secure points in the win against Gold Star. Michigan Stars, my bad, the other team from Michigan. Akinkoye cannot corral this one, falling for Savannah in their white with green numbered uniforms. Joel Bunting finds Hargreaves. Pass intercepted, Forca on it. Finds Gonzalez, finding Burnett. Burnett looking to get around Max Rogova, and instead will go backward for Alex Sutton. Kusayan back for Sutton. Not sure if either was necessarily expecting the ball at that exact moment. Goes for Akinkoye. He's got plenty of room on his left. That room is closed down. Nice tackle. Got all ball on that one from number 8, Aaron Martinez. And Sutton will boot this one deep into the middle of the field. Bobcats lose the header, but gain the second one, lose the third, and Akinkoye will tap it for his captain. Forca for Filerman. Bunting closes off his space. Akinkoye, weak pass and a hard challenge by Filerman, and a free kick will be awarded here as our referee today, Brian Albert, pressed into some early duty, try to stop Filerman as they put arms around each other and go for a short walk. Hard foul by Filerman concedes a potentially dangerous free kick here for Savannah. Although, if you've taken a look at Savannah's record this season, they are, to put it mildly, not great. Savannah has a minus 25 goal differential this season, and they've won just one game. They're riding in today on an 8-game losing streak. Their last goal was against the Bobcats. Their last goal came on a penalty kick by Alexandros Iarides, who is coming off the bench today for Savannah. And their last goal from free play was a Joel Bunting header in their lone victory of the season against Club de Leon. It has been a rough go for Savannah in their first professional season. I would say tough sledding, but I'm not exactly sure what kind of sledding action there is in Georgia. I was recently corrected on that when I spoke that in Florida, and my brother said, there's no sledding here. Header comes in, and Rogova gets a touch to it, but it goes backward, and it'll roll toward the touchline. He keeps it in play, finding Moyers. Solomon forces the issue, and pass goes over Solomon for Moyers again. Bounces off of a Bobcat, and that'll be a throw-in for Savannah, trying to get it right into the box. And Poussayan is the first one to it. Has some help from Burnett, finding Richard Forca in the middle of the field. Filerman looking for Espinal. Espinal has 3 players surrounding him, and eventually it's taken off of him. Akinkoye wins the ball away from Bunting. A good defensive close from Cameron Schneider. Kept Savannah in it momentarily. Akinkoye has 1 goal so far on this season, looking to set up the pass. De Leon is the first one to it ahead of Abdou Yam. Falls in. Espinal cannot swing his boot to it. A header comes in. Potentially dangerous play, and referee will stop action as De Leon put his foot up to get the ball. Sam Solomon lowered his head to try to get a head down. And yes, it is dangerous. It's just one of those things where I'm not sure what either player was supposed to do in that exact scenario. Nonetheless, it'll be a free kick for the Bobcats a couple dozen yards away. As Espinal is going to be the one to stand over it. His free kick was what led to the Abdou Yam goal to get Maryland back in the game against Michigan to tie things up. And a few minutes later, Malik Tom was the one who put Maryland ahead for good against Michigan. That victory against Michigan also notable as team owner and coach George Yunshai was given a red card from the bench for reasons that I am not 100% sure of. Espinal floats it into the box, headed away, rolling toward the byline and some jersey jostling there. As it looks like last touch off of Savannah, it'll be a corner for the Bobcats. Number 18, Abdou Yam, is going to be the one to take it out of Dakar, Senegal. One-time UConn Husky. Players are between the 6 and the 18. Hands go up, ball comes in, ball falls down, and Burnett couldn't swing it, and Forca comes through, and it rolls wide of the net off the shot by Filerman. That'll be a goal kick for Crichton. So, more about Jack's dad, Paul. At 36 years old, he had his face scanned as part of FIFA 11, and it was the last time he was listed as a contract player for Sheffield United. So, if anybody has a copy of FIFA 11 on their BlackBerry App Store, you can go find it. No, I'm serious. I looked up all the platforms FIFA 11 was available on, and the BlackBerry Play was one of the things you could do that on. Granted, your battery would run out before the full time minutes, but that's not important right now. Trust me, I have a long drive to get to the stadium. I think of a lot of jokes on the way here. Filerman has the throw in now for Maryland. Yam, one touch pass for Espinal. Savannah's doing a good job trying to limit Espinal's chances as they send three around him again. Wise to do so. He is the second leading scorer in the league and by far the leading scorer on the Bobcats with nine. Hussein, quick touch for Forca. Burak Nkoye finds Forca on the left foot. That capable left foot finds a pass for Espinal, and it's poked ahead. Bunting now finds Crichton. Crichton out of his area and will send it to the midfield line. Forca wins the header. It falls for Aaron Martinez. Spinning free for Hargreaves. Bunting cannot get on this pass as Filerman broke it up. Akinkoye for Gonzalez. Back for Richard Forca. Thought about going back for Sutton and will instead go halfway there for Poussaint. Thank you again for joining us on FIFA Plus. My name is Max Wapoff. At 15 minutes, thank you for making us part of your Saturday night entertainment. It is a scoreless game so far. Maryland looking to change that here. Pass gets behind the defense. Bunting comes free, and it's broken up. Wanted to set up Espinal breaking through the middle and could not do so. Philip Burnett got behind the defensive line, and Espinal stayed onside. Burnett breaks it into the box again, and Crichton, he fumbles it, but nobody's there. Jack Crichton having a hard time on that one, facing away from the sun. So Jack, he followed in his dad's gloves to make his way to America, playing college soccer at Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, as a foul is awarded for Savannah to get possession, and they'll send Crichton up to take the kick. So Crichton played in the 2019 and 2021 seasons for the Eagles, which if it's an aeronautical university, I think they miss a great opportunity for a space pun. Like, I don't know, the Embry-Riddle Astronauts. I think that'd be more fun. Too many schools are astronauts. Too many schools are animals. Hussein can't win the header, but it falls for Sutton. And Sutton thought about going quickly, but had a man right there next to him. Rolled for Forca for Akinkoye. Sutton swings it back to the right side of the offensive attack for Poussaint. Finding Burnett, it goes out of play, out of the touchline. Burnett could not keep it in. This pass rolls errant for Sutton, as it doesn't look like anybody is going to run there to force him to grab it off the ground. And he'll play short for Forca. Forca runs onto the rolling ball. Pass for Espinal. Espinal trying to break away from Bunting. Pass just a little bit behind Malik Tom. Gonzalez. Espinal again, harassed by Moyers. Moyers with the steal. Now one-on-one comes Alex Woods, and losing control of the ball and control of himself as he falls to the turf. Hussein, pass away from Richard Forca. It'll roll into the penalty area. Alex Sutton will be the one there for a quick pass from Manny Gonzalez. This pass is just a bit too long, and Jack Crichton has it at his feet. Seventeen and a half gone by in a scoreless contest thus far. Last time these two clubs faced off against each other, it was a 4-1 victory for the Maryland Bobcats. That was the last home contest for Maryland, as they then went on a two-game road swing. Savannah has played five contests in between then and now, and they lost all five on shutouts. Pass up ahead, over the head of Aaron Martinez. Pass for Filerman. Filerman finds Akinkoye. Akinkoye waiting for options to develop. Martinez closed in on him fast from behind. Gonzalez for Poussaint, and Gonzalez didn't like something about his pass there. Gonzalez drops it to himself. He gets on his left foot, goes down, foul awarded. Alex Cow, you might be able to hear from the bench yelling, push up, push up. And I don't think he's calling for the calisthenic exercise. I think he's calling for his offense to move forward up the field. Forca retreats, and De Leon forces him into a pass back to his keeper. Two Bobcats go up for the header, and it goes over both of them. Falls between two more Bobcats as Akinkoye can't get it away from Hargreaves fast enough. Bounces off of Akinkoye here. Woods, breaking free, finds Rugova, and Burnett is going to close him off. Off of Rugova, I believe that is a goal kick, and Maryland getting a bit fortunate there. As Alex Cow is now roaming his touchline, clearly not happy with his team's effort tonight so far. The third place Maryland Bobcats have a chance to close the gap on second place Albion San Diego with a win tonight. San Diego is off tonight. They don't play until tomorrow against the Los Angeles Force. Ball rolls out for a throw-in for the Bobcats. Comes back into Akinkoye. Savannah, on the other hand, they're the only club in the league so far without 10 points. Moyers, middle of the field, broken up by Poussaint. As a player for Savannah is down, I thought I heard a whistle momentarily, but it looks like Maryland's going to keep going here. Espinal loses it off of his foot, broken up on the play by Chandler Vaughn, and now the referee is going to come over and check on an injured player for Savannah. As the man down on the field is number 8, Aaron Martinez. As the team physio is now going to head out and check on him. Aaron Martinez is from Greeley, Colorado, north of Denver and southeast of Fort Collins. Martinez started college career with Salt Lake Community College in the NJCAA, and he featured prominently in two seasons in 2017 and 2018. He then moved to... Sorry, just trying to get later into my notes. As it looks like he's going to have to come off for a brief moment here. As Martinez, he's pleading with the fourth official that he's fine. But 21 minutes into the game, and Savannah traveling light on substitutes, they cannot afford to have to use one here in the first half. I'm sure their head coach, David Proctor, has a plan. And Martinez is being waved on. So we're back to 11-on-11 after maybe 3 seconds of 10-on-11. But yeah, Savannah brought only one defensive sub, one midfield sub, and 3 forward subs, which granted they're playing with 5 forwards like it's foosball. A hard foul on Jasilin Poussaint gives the ball to Maryland deep in their own end. Has a lot of hand jostling and for position on that ball. As this is probably not what Maryland wanted. They would have probably preferred the goal kick, but with Sutton's roll, it ends up being at about the same spot that one would be just further down the field. Akinkoye, Filerman on a slow rolling pass. Miscommunication there, thought Solomon was going to stay back. Moyers for Hargreaves. Bunting. Bunting cannot get around two men, finds the release point with Hargreaves. Espinal unable to run it down at the midfield line. Throw in for the Clovers. Schneider in for Bunting. Taken away by Filerman. Gonzalez finds Forca. Keeping it along the back line for Filerman. The left side patrol. Akinkoye, triangle back for Richard Forca. Sutton, and this has not been going great for Maryland to break out of their defensive third. Forca once again backward now. Burnett looking for options. Finds one up ahead. Malik Tom just able to get onto that one. The pass comes up. Solomon is just offside. So Bobcats are going to have to throw away that possession there. Not offside by much, but in today's day and age, offside by a little still means offside. I don't know if there is still passive offside as there used to be in the decades prior. Crichton will send it deep, and unable to find a teammate, he finds Filerman in his orange boots. Filerman sends it long. This one's onside for Abdou Yam. Yam, just able to settle it down to himself, into the six-yard. Crichton comes out to stop it. Well done by Jack Crichton to handle the bouncing ball, as Abdou Yam just could not handle it. Well done, though. That was a tough pass from Filerman, and Yam was able to control it just enough to get it into the penalty area with some control. Crichton just beat him to the bounce. Long pass looking for Woods. Finds the head of Burnett. Rugova. Rugova sends one way high and wide over Sutton and over everybody. And so a goal kick for the Manhattan-born keeper. Sutton uncharacteristically keeping that goal kick short. Instead, we'll send it up here with the front four. Couldn't find Malik Tom. Hargreaves spills and misses. Hard tackle on Solomon. And referee's going to allow play to keep going. Akinkoye looking for Espinal on the wing. Darwin's got it at the touchline. Moving it forward. Filerman waits for options to develop in the box. Keeping it for a one-time Detroit City FC teammate. Espinal puts it into the area. Akinkoye could not run that one down. A good box out from Daniel De Leon leaves the ball for Jack Crichton. Crichton is going to send his players deep, but he'll keep Daniel De Leon back as an option. And now he's sending him forward. Gets underneath it and sends it long. Richard Forca gets a forehead to it. Schneider. Poked for the foot of Poussaion. Over the head of Yam, finds De Leon. Gonzalez, one touches it up. Yam puts it down on the ground. Vaughn, up ahead for Rugova. Pushed off of the ball by Burnett, playing great defense as he normally does here at the Maryland Soccer Plex. Long pass here. Espinal, he's got space. He's got moves. He's got people. Offside, though. Bit of a late offside call as Maryland was at least a dozen or so yards ahead of where the offside line was flagged down. And now the Bobcats, they're unable to get going again. 27th minute of action, neither team with a shot on goal thus far. Jack Crichton probably had the biggest chance of them all taking away the bounce off of Abdou Yam. De Leon. Waiting with patience and had his options closed off by Yam. Back for Crichton. Finds Hunt. Hunt looking for Rugova, bypassing the midfield. Off of Burnett. And this will give the Maryland backline a chance to reset itself. But another throw in for Savannah. Throw in comes to Hunt at the center back position. Gonzalez wins the ball to Akinkoye. Setting up here through Yam. Yam gets the pass away from Bunting for Filerman. Filerman back for Yam. Filerman's going to go run up into the forward spot. Forca, not the greatest pass, ends up getting back for Poussaion, and Sutton will come out to reset things. Forca finds Poussaion on a multiple hopper. Poussaion opts to go forward, finds the pass for Solomon. Burnett looking for Tom. Got it. Entering the 29th minute. Solomon has it on a run and bodying position. Looks like last touch off of Savannah. It'll be a corner kick. Solomon opting to play for the corner as opposed to going for the goal. The choices you make in a split-second judgment call as Abdou-Yam is making the slow walk over to the loose ball. So Yam will stand on top of it as Maryland looks like they're going to put five, maybe six runners into the box. They've got five in there now as Espinal and Gonzalez are hanging out on the outside. Two hands go up. Players make their runs. Ball comes in just beyond the goal. Filerman puts it on. Moyers boots it away toward the Savannah bench, and it'll roll. Maryland keeping it quick. Kusayan back for Gonzalez. Gonzalez looking for Solomon to set one up. Solomon has it. One-on-one with Hunt. Looked to be off of Solomon last. He gets control right at the byline. Filerman. And this one rolls off of Savannah last. It'll be a throw-in for Maryland. Akinkoye, Filerman. Filerman inside for Espinal. Espinal can't get that one into the box. Gonzalez on the bouncing ball. Filerman puts it in straight for Crichton. Header comes through. Who had that touch last? Maryland. It'll be a goal kick. Abdou-Yam broke in. And Crichton, he got a hand to it, but it was last off of Abdou-Yam. Some of those dangerous looks we've seen for Maryland so far in the early 30 minutes of action. But we're still scoreless here for Maureen Hendricks Field. Crichton runs up, sends a swing of the right leg well beyond the midfield line. Rogova cannot win the header. Burnett was the one that first got to it. Falls for Vaughn, back for Hunt. Hunt comes forward, sends a pass well long, and Sutton has it at the handlebars. Filerman making a deep run of the midfield line. Nice sliding block from Hargreaves as Filerman spills him to the ground, and that's Filerman's second hard tackle of this game, and it looks like he's going to be given a yellow card. Yes, he is. James Filerman goes into the book. Into the book at the 31st minute of action. Filerman, a bit uncharacteristic there, as that is his first yellow card of the season. Wow. Definitely a bit unusual for James to be parted by an official. Now Savannah, they're not really sure what to do next. De Leon just goes center back to center back for Hunt. Chandler Vaughn breaking into the middle, finding Hargreaves. Breaks free. Martinez cannot get it to Bunting in time. Sutton will come out to grab it. Now Filerman. As I'm not sure what this does to play into Alex Cow's potential substitutions. He has two defenders on the bench today. Brandon John, who would be making his team debut if he came into the match, and Abdellah Mansour, who is no stranger to the referee's book. He leads the team with six yellow cards this season. Kusayan cannot get control of the ball. Rogova sends him hard to the ground. It's going to look like it's going to just be a goal kick as the referee, Brian Albert, is going to just allow the players to tackle each other. This game has been pretty physical here in the early 33 minutes of action. Richard Forca, spun back to his keeper, has some space, moves up ahead. Yam, back for Forca. A good crowd on hand here at Maureen Hendricks Field. We thank you again for being part of your Saturday Night Entertainment. Solomon making a deep run. Solomon is behind De Leon, and Crichton sends this one up into the air, and it will land two rows in front of us. A quick throw in here for Maryland. They didn't wait for it to even come down. Well done by a fan to protect himself. It was very well done. Now a foul on Maryland again gives control back to Savannah as Chandler Vaughn is the one on the field. Foul came from Malik Tom, it looked like, crashing in to take the ball off of Vaughn. Crichton stands over this elevated goal kick, as he might be on a full-strength kick, able to get this one into the offensive third. As Darwin Espinal is still having words with Brian Albert, you may not be able to change the mind about a previous call, but you can influence the next one. Sometimes that's more important. Head comes in, Poussaint, and dangerous play ruled as a Savannah Clover swung a foot as another Bobcats player stuck a head down to put the ball into control. Forca finding Feilerman on a yellow card. Pass up ahead, Yam. One touch goes back to him. Espinal, big tackle here from Schneider. No foul is awarded as Espinal goes down. Sutton out to challenge, gets the ball, keeping it away from Alex Woods as Espinal looks like he's going to be fine, but it's the principle of the matter right now for Maryland. Schneider came real close there to potentially going into the book himself. Long pass here. Vaughn won the header, but it goes into touch. I was talking with a couple of the Maryland Bobcats staffers prior to tonight's game, and I said something to the effect of this game has the potential to be either a surprise or a bloodbath. And right now, it might be both. There's a lot of chippiness and a lot of aggressive tackles out there. But it looks like a corner here for Maryland as Abdou Yam goes over to grab it. Once again, Maryland has a chance here with a set piece to set up their offense. Yam stands a few feet away from the ball, puts both hands up once more. Players make their runs, comes into the middle of the area. Feilerman could not corral it, and neither could Espinal. Ball is cleared. Burnett making a deep run for it back to his line. He'll let it go out of play for a throw. Gets it quickly to Poussaint. Sutton. Sutton has some experience as a striker from his youth days, so he's not entirely uncomfortable up ahead of his goalie area. Long pass away from Chandler Vaughn and Malik Tom. As this will be goalie, puts it out of play for a goal kick. The next game for these Bobcats will be the Independent Cup Finals on August 19th, next Saturday night. So that's going to be a great matchup, as it'll be Bobcats versus Bobcats. The Maryland Bobcats reserve team is going to be facing the Maryland Bobcats senior team for some silverware and some bragging rights as a result. Crichton bangs the grass off of his boots, puts up his left hand, gives a few steps, and makes a run for it. Rogova finds Hargreaves, Moyers, for Hunt, for De Leon. Closing in on the final few minutes of this first half, and neither team has challenged either goalkeeper very much. Straight to Poussaint, direct pass through the middle. Solomon saw it late, and Crichton is the first one to it. Crichton once again, and this one will send way beyond. Poussaint swing and a miss. Woods cannot get around Burnett. Burnett sends a man down to the area, in the area. Brian Albert, once again, is going to rule that was fair. Akinkoye for Poussaint, for Forca. Whether you win by one or you win by three, 3 points are still 3 points. But Maryland is probably not going to be happy knowing that they got a 4-1 spot against this team last time they were here. Savannah has lost 5 since then, and 8 in a row overall. And Maryland is still unable to break through this midfield for Savannah. Feilerman pokes it up ahead over Bunting. Some hand jostling there, finding Espinal. Espinal is going to use his breakaway speed to get away. Bunting made a dangerous tackle, and even for the attempt, Bunting is going to get yellow carded for it. He did not take Espinal down, but that is a dangerous play right there. As for Bunting, that's his third yellow of the season. As it'll give a free kick for Maryland on their half of midfield. Whistle goes, finds Gonzalez. Gonzalez poking it in. Solomon had it poke up ahead. Bunting swung and missed on that pass. And Feilerman's pass went long. And this will be a throw in for the Bobcats. As Feilerman and Forca hold the ball each, and Feilerman throws his away as Forca puts his into play. Gonzalez gets it for Forca. He managed to get it away from Aaron Martinez, who wanted to intercept the straight-ahead pass. Espinal keeps his balance. Espinal finds a nice pass off of the back of Abdou Yam. Falls for James Feilerman. Pokes it through one player. Bodied off of the ball, and Feilerman goes down in a heap. He's not going to get much sympathy from Brian Albert on this one. Albert has already booked Feilerman in this game. Akin Koye. Developing options here. Espinal, Feilerman, Abdou Yam on a break. He is onside. Yam files it to the corner flag, breaking away. Akin Koye. Gonzalez breaks it into the box. Solomon, he's offside again. This one rolls into the net, but it's offside as Solomon was just off again. Second time Solomon's been caught offside to take away a potential scoring opportunity. This one ended up rolling into the net too. But our assistant referee judges it was unfair. So an elevated goal kick between the 18 and the 6. As Crichton stands over it and sending everybody forward. Burnett wins the header. Solomon pokes it behind for Vaughn. Rogova wanted to play that off his feet, ends up falling for him. Rogova runs right into Forca, who loses the ball. Feilerman looking to get to his wing. Pokes it way up ahead. Solomon cannot get there fast enough. As Crichton calmly escorts this one back to his crease and finds De Leon. Daniel finds Cameron, who goes back to Daniel. So we enter the 42nd minute of action. Hunt. Vaughn. And Vaughn's going to go back as his space is closed on the other side by Malik Tom. De Leon back for Crichton. Maryland's forwards are pressing their back line to make quicker decisions. Manuel Gonzalez thought this play was offside, but we're going to keep playing through Rogova, playing in his second matchup with Savannah after starting the season with Gold Star FC. Schneider on the right wing, sends this one into the box, well long, looking for Rogova. Back into the area, Gonzalez cleanly and calmly pokes it ahead for Malik Tom. Tom's got plenty of speed. He's got three runners with him and makes the pass here for Sam Solomon. Solomon's onside this time. Abdou Yam looking for the run into the middle of the area, chested out of play by Daniel De Leon. A late first half corner here as Daniel De Leon kept his arms away from the ball, did not allow that to go off of his potentially unpredictable feet, and just chested it out of play. Abdou Yam making another slow walk to that right corner flag, a place that he has become rather familiar with in this contest. Once again, Maryland puts six at the edge of the box. Espinal, Forca, Feilerman, Akin Koye, Palm, and Solomon. With Burnett now making a run for seven, Gonzalez is hanging out at the edge of the area, and through Cyan, looks like he's the only one back. Yam puts both hands up. Cross comes in, and Well defended. Burnett slides this one through, slicing in. Akinkoye pokes it up in the air. Espinal looking to make a rundown on it. And at the byline, he's able to keep it in. Who was that last off of? Savannah. A throw in for the Bobcats. Entering the last 90 seconds of normal time to be added. Not sure how much time is going to be added by our fourth official, Jose Zepeda Aguilera. Savannah pokes this one up ahead. Forca crashes in on it, bodied toward the ball, and rolls it towards Alex Sutton. Sutton running back for it, keeping it in front of him. Sends a long boot. Hargreaves takes a spill on Akinkoye. Header by Rugova. He's got plenty of hops in those boots as he got up to get that one. Vaughn kept it away from Solomon. Gonzalez and Akinkoye teamed up to get it back as far as Schneider. Philip Burnett. Now the Bobcats are pushing some pace here. Burnett, waiting for options, finds one through. Poke toward the byline, and it's out of play for another corner kick for the Bobcats. This might be the last action here in regular time of this first half. So far, Maryland has not been successful on their free kicks and set pieces. Quick take from Manny Gonzalez. Up in the air, Forca got the header, and it'll fall on top of the net. It hit the net, just, you know, on the wrong side of it for the Bobcats, that is. 45 minutes have been played. There's no Daktronics scoreboard down there, so I don't know how much time has been added on. Four minutes is the signal that I'm getting. As it looks like 4 minutes is going to be taken to both benches. So at 7:50 p.m., we thank you again for joining us here. And at 7:54 or so, we'll have the end of the first half. Passes errant here. Akinkoye finding it through. It looks like the Bobcats are onside here. Akinkoye at the byline gets it through across the face of goal, headed out of there. It looks like the Maryland Bobcats will not be having a corner kick here for some reason, as potentially a foul at that back post with Chandler Vaughn is down and a bit slower to get up than regular. So Crichton will roll it to the spot of the foul that was spotted. Maryland's offense coming alive here in the last 15 minutes of this first half, but those lively moments have been unable to get through. Rolled right to Sutton. That's the first shot on goal of this contest, and it comes from Savannah, and it's a high percentage save for Sutton. Espinal spins this one through. He's got plenty of magic in those boots. Can he make another magical moment here at the Soccerplex? He's surrounded by three Clovers, now four, as he is able to keep control of the ball. Akinkoye. Back for Poussaint. Maryland keeping control in their offensive half. Pass is chunked, but it ends up falling for Hargreaves. Bunting rolling onto it. Gets it through Forca's legs. Bunting has some space. Closed off instead by Filerman. And Bunting has to return back. Martinez. Hargreaves. For Chandler Vaughn. Moyers. At the center line, poked out of play. Malik Tom forced a bad pass. We've played about 2 minutes of the added four. Yam off of a body for Savannah, and Moyers pokes it to the center circle. The Bobcats will start the second half with the ball, but they'd like to start it with the lead as well. Filerman up ahead, Solomon making a break on it. De Leon pokes it out for a throw-in. The ball is on the field as well as in the hands of Espinal. Espinal puts his in before the ball came out of play. Espinal steps around two defenders. Can't get around a third. Instead, finds the pass here. Malik Tom, he has some space. Malik Tom, off the bar! Burnett, back for Tom. Still dangerous here. Edge of the area. Gonzalez puts up a golazo chance, and it rolls through. Akinkoye can't get control. Hargreaves hooks it out ahead. Huge chance for Malik Tom. He set up the shot, beat Crichton, and it rang off of the bar. Chested down, hard foul. A late free kick right in the handlebar is going to be given to the Bobcats as Vaughn and Hunt teamed up to take down, it looked like, Malik Tom. Malik Tom with the best chance of this game thus far with that huge shot right off of the right post. So a chance here late for Maryland to take a lead into the first half. This looks like it'll probably be the last act of this first half as we are into the third minute and potentially the fourth coming up soon of the added four. Darwin Espinal standing over the ball. It is a six-person wall. Filerman Espinal comes through right into the wall. Filerman pokes it through and didn't need to do much with it as Crichton falls on top of it to hear the first half whistle. Savannah saved by the bell as Maryland pushing deep into that first half to get that first goal. But Savannah Clovers, they did not break. It is a scoreless first half for the Bobcats and Clovers. We thank you again for joining us on our new broadcast partner, FIFA Plus. We will be back for the second half on behalf of all of us here at the Bobcats FC. We hope you stay tuned for the second half of action. And welcome back for the second half of action. Maryland will start with the ball, moving from left to right, and Savannah will be starting on defense, moving from right to left. Alex Sutton and Jack Crichton will move back into the creases for their respective teams. Two substitutes to tell you about for Savannah, as it looks like no new places have come on for Maryland. As a fresh 45 is on referee Brian Albert's clock, and Abdou-Yam kicks us off. Let's have some more fun tonight. Joel Bunting has been subbed off for Savannah. He was on a yellow card, and considering the nature of the game tonight, and potentially getting more chippy as the game goes along, probably the right move to substitute a guy off who has the yellow card. Aaron Martinez is also off in their places. Alexandros Iarides and Andres Sanchez, as Poussaion pokes this one away from Alex Woods. There are just four subs remaining on the bench, three for players and one for a keeper for Savannah, as Malik Tom makes a run toward the byline, keeping this one in play, pokes it into the area, moves over the header of Solomon, and Crichton comes out with gloves to make it save. Rogova making a run down, Poussaion bodying him off the ball, and Rogova pushes him down to the ground. And a foul is going to be awarded. It was last off of Poussaion heading out of play, but with the foul, it'll stay with the Bobcats. As a player is down well behind the play over by Savannah's penalty area. So before we get started on the restarting play, Brian Albert is going to run over and check on him. Alexandros Iarides, one of the second half substitutes, holds the odd distinction of being the most recent goal scorer for Savannah. He scored the penalty kick goal against Maryland on June 10th. It has been a rough go for Savannah since then. They have not scored a goal in their last five matchups. And in case anybody was curious, they have conceded 12. Maryland, however, held off the scoreboard in that first half of action. As it looks like this is... It looks like this is more serious than first look. The physio is calling for a substitute here. So already Savannah has used, looking like their third substitute of the game, as a player is going to have to come on. And the man coming on, it looks like it's going to be Michael Green, number 16, for the Clovers. Green is from Goose Creek, South Carolina. The Clover Scout noticed Green when he was playing at Stratford High School in 2022 and offered him a chance to turn professional and forego his senior season. The local ABC affiliate, South Carolina WCIV, inaccurately reported that the Clovers were a USL 1 team in announcing the signing. So, you know, that's how that goes. So it looks like Green is going to be the one to come on here, as player needs assistance walking off of the field. He's able to walk at least, which is good, but needs two men on his shoulders to help him out. So an early first couple of minutes substitution on top of the two right at the half, and Savannah is down to two substitutes left in this contest. So now De Leon has been relieved of duties to carry off his teammate, and it looks like Green is going to take the center back role that Ford Hunt had. Ball had been stopped in the Bobcats' third, so a quick kick from Sutton sends this ball deep. As Ford Hunt comes off for Savannah, that's three substitutes now for the Clovers. Breaking in Tom, taken away by Vaughn. Pass goes through to Crichton, who boots it deep to the midfield line. Rogova loses control of the ball. Malik Tom had the best chance of that first half, bringing one right off of the right post. Burnett on the short pass for Solomon. Solomon has it down to his feet, and Savannah able to clear the ball. Poussaion taking over as a center back role with the wingers of Filerman and Burnett. Burnett keeps this one on the turf, gets around, and cannot get through Chandler Vaughn. Vaughn pokes it ahead well offside here. Nice try, Alex Woods. Well offside. Cyan gets play restarted. Breaking through, Solomon cannot get there in time as the first touch from Michael Green puts this one into the far side seating section. Most of the people who are here are situated on the near side seating section, which, you know, there are concessions here, there are bathrooms here. Comes in and Abdou-Yam could not get on that one. Mason Moyers was the one to take the chance away. Foul here, Savannah gets control of the ball. Moyers comes from a soccer family. Moyers' uncle Steve had a great professional career in America for its era, including 8 seasons in the NASL for various teams like the St. Louis Stars, the California Surf, and the New York Cosmos, including a spell on the U.S. men's national team. Into the box, Rugova. Rugova, penalty's going to be awarded! It looks like a dangerous pass in the box is going to get Savannah a chance to go up 1-0 here in the 51st minute. Rugova had the chance at it, and I'm not sure what our referee saw there. Brian Albert called a penalty on an attempted clearance. And it looks like Zach Hargreaves is going to be the one to step up and take it. He's the one talking with the official. And my apologies, it's Max Rugova. In just his second game with Savannah, he's now going to take the penalty. Well, let's see what Rugova can do. Sutton has to keep his line. Here's a penalty chance. Into the goal! Max Rugova puts Savannah in front. And the Clovers are on the board. Sutton chose left. Max also went left, but he went to his left. My, how things change in this game. Max Rugova puts Savannah in front 1-0. And now Maryland, despite handling most of the offense in this half and most of the offense in this game, are playing from behind. The Overland Park Kansas native has his team in front with his first of the season. At least for Savannah. According to Transfer Market's website, he had 2 with Gold Star Detroit prior to being taken off of that team. Gonzalez now. Maryland playing from behind is not something they are necessarily accustomed to here at this park. However, they did get a come-from-behind victory against Michigan earlier in this month. Chunk pass finds Malik Tom. Tom cannot get away from defenders and cannot poke this one through to any friendly feet. Hussain for Forca. Up ahead, Filerman. Filerman into the box, and it's closed off well by Green. Ball falls and a foul is taken. Savannah is going to get control back. Tough break for Maryland on a swing of the boot that was ruled to be dangerous play. Max Rugova converts the penalty. As if there's one way that Alex Sutton allows goals, it is by the penalty kick. He has conceded each of the penalty kicks that he has faced, which, you know, not exactly unusual for a keeper, as Crichton puts this one back into play. But there have been a lot of penalties. And Rugova, I'm not sure what was missed there by Brian Albert, but Rugova jumped straight into Philip Burnett as Burnett was trying to throw the ball in. And apparently that was not worthy of a foul. Filerman spins around the defender, puts it right into the back of Mason Moyers, headed away, finds Green. Vaughn can't control the first time. And it bounces off of the sliding block of Solomon. The last place team in the league has themselves a 1-0 lead courtesy of a Max Rugova penalty kick. Hussein, back for Sutton. Sutton has some space, uses it, puts a short pass. Malik Tom now taking away on the steal. Chandler Vaughn, that's a foul. And they're not going to call over Vaughn to give a yellow card. Tom had plenty of space to make a run for that. And Chandler Vaughn taking away a clear goal-scoring opportunity, at least from my perspective. I'm not the one on the field. And Alex Cow on the bench side is also not happy about this. Darwin Espinal now has the ball at his feet. And he'll send Gonzalez to his right. A two-person wall. Plenty of men in the box for the Bobcats. Playing from behind. Two hands go up. Ball comes in. Meets a header. And it bounces around. Bicycle kicked out of there. Player was offside, though. Offside called by the near official, as well as by our match referee. And it'll roll for Savannah. So Jack Crichton has it at the offside spot. And he will send it center left of the field. Burnett, Moyers, and Tom battling for it. Tom pokes it up. Hargreaves got it. Hargreaves' slow pass eventually finds his intended target. Rogova back heel could not get there in time. Malik Tom keeping control and balance. Nicely done by the young Rockville native. Rogova pokes it up and not out of play. Green back into his area. And behind the play, Philip Burnett is down. He's able to get up on his own power. There is an evaluator here from the U.S. Soccer Federation for referees. He is making notes on a legal pad. I was able to spot him during halftime. Didn't introduce myself or say anything to influence his judgment, but I'm seeking to let all of you know that there is an evaluator here. These sorts of referee evaluators exist in all sports. I was at a college basketball game earlier this calendar year, but last basketball season. And I watched a NCAA ref evaluator making notes on all of the whistles and non-whistles. Corner kick here for Maryland, this time on the left side of their formation. A lot came on the right side in the last half. Ball is going to come in short into the area, and it bounces free. Gonzalez running it down. Gonzalez pokes it back through, and it bounced, looked like off of Savannah last, so Crichton comes out and stops it before going out for another corner kick. Jack Crichton, the Doncaster, England native, is going to send his center backs up. Yam and Solomon are forcing him into a decision here. Goes for Rogova, the goal scorer here. Not the worst idea for a keeper to find the most recent goal scorer for your side, but this pass is well long and out of play. Impressive boot by Crichton, but could not find a friendly foot. Sutton will play this one short for Filerman. Entering now the 59th minute of action, we thank you again for joining us here on this lovely Saturday evening from Boyds, Maryland at the Maureen Hendricks Field. My name is Max Walpoff, and on behalf of all of us here at the Maryland Bobcats, thank you for making us part of your Saturday night entertainment. Keeping it along the byline, rolled in and out of play. Corner kick, it looks like. I am incorrect. It is going to be a goal kick. Potentially offside, actually. I'm right the third time. It's offside. Crichton will pick the ball up and roll it forward, well ahead of where the offside line was. Sends it deep. At the edge of the offensive third, chested down by Rogova. Came close to a handball. Woods taking it one-on-one against Burnett. He'll lose that battle. Gonzalez finds Burnett back for Manny. Gonzalez and out of play. Burnett could not control the pass from Manuel. Quick throw in from Moyers. Finds Hargreaves. Entering now 60 minutes of action. There are 30 minutes left to go. As our assistant referee, a yellow card's been shown here to, it looks like, Alex Woods of Savannah for a play off of the ball. And it looks like Maryland is going to get possession at the spot of the off-the-ball foul as Hargreaves, the captain, came over and gave a stern talking to Woods. Yeah, this has been a chippy contest. It's not for the faint of heart out there. Woods, though, at 20 years of age, he was born the day after Thanksgiving of 2002, November 27th. From Savannah, Georgia, so he's a local for this team. He played one season for Coker University in the Division II South Atlantic Conference, featured in only two contests for the team, and after that underwhelming season, he joined the Clovers professionally. So Benjamin Mackay looks like he's going to come in for Savannah. He's lined up at the fourth official's box. Maryland looking to tie this contest up before that can happen. Off of the side of Moyers, he had his arm inside, so long pass here from Crichton. Forca is just going to allow Sutton to handle it, and he does. Alex Woods, the most recent yellow card. There have been three in this contest. Filerman is still on the field. He has one. Bunting is off the field. He got one late in that first half. And Woods here in the second has the third of the contest. There probably could be more, given how aggressive this game has been. But, I'm not the one making those decisions. Akinkoye, running free to the touchline. He's got two men around him, finds the release point with Espinal. Akinkoye now with speed on the far side. Akinkoye keeping possession and the ball taken off the ball, and a foul is going to be awarded here. Referee not reaching into his pockets as Akinkoye wins the free kick for the Bobcats. 63rd minute of action. As it looks like Benjamin Mackay might be waiting for a few more plays before he comes onto the field. Savannah content to be patient with their fourth substitute. As actually they're going to signal him to come on now. And I think they're going to bring off Woods. So Mackay is going to come on, and he will replace Alex Woods. So Savannah does not want to get caught here going down to 10 men, so they've brought off both of their players that have come on with yellow cards. Bunting came off at the first half whistle, and Mackay here is going to come on to replace Woods. Ball comes in, punched out, it rolls into the goal! Somehow the Bobcats have tied this game. Savannah's appealing for offside. They're not going to get it. We're tied at one. Oh my. I don't know who got last touch on that one. The free kick came, it looked like potentially from Akinkoye, and was it a goal? Oh my. I think they waved off the goal. Handball. The fourth official is signaling to that it was a handball. The fourth official is signaling to Alex Cow it was a handball. Man, I didn't see it. Corner kick here for Savannah. This might be a huge swing in momentum going from potentially 1-1 to potentially up by 2. Savannah hasn't had a whole lot of free kicks in this contest and definitely not a lot of corner kicks. As they'll try one here from the left side of the offense. I do apologize. It is a 1-0 game still. Savannah's got the lead. Header goes in. Sutton comes out calmly to make a grab on it. Good thing, too. We're trying to get the on-screen graphics to reflect the actual score. It is 1-0 Savannah. The referee pointed to the center circle as if it was a good goal and restarted play. Man, what a contest tonight. This is weird. Burnett off of bodies goes for Rogova, finding Mackay. Hargreaves spins around and waits for it. Vaughn up ahead for Rogova off his back heel and out of play. As this is the first time he's been on the near side of the field in a while. Solomon offside. He has some running room, but was unable to get to the ball on in an onside position. I was about to make my point about Max Rogova. This is the first time I've seen that face tattoo he has up close. Quite a choice in that young man's life. Quite a choice. So Maryland trails 1-0 off of the head of Rogova. And everybody is going to keep playing. Gonzalez, Poussaion. Out ahead. Up ahead. Solomon looks like he's onside this time. Solomon, he's hard, head down to the floor. Referee is reaching into his pockets now. He's pulled out a yellow card. The substitute, Michael Green, has gotten himself into the book at 67 minutes of action. As Alex Cal looks like he's going to have to make a decision here. He's going to bring on Caleb Pritchett. Caleb Pritchett is in the fourth official substitution box, ready to come on at a moment's notice. Darwin Espinal is the one standing over it. Sam Solomon looks like he knows it's him coming off, so he's going to run off now, or he's going to. As Solomon has come off, Pritchett has come on. So Solomon subbed out in his second start of this young season. Found himself offside quite a bit, and Pritchett comes back into the first team. And this would be quite a way to introduce yourself. Espinal spins it to the back post. Header goes away from goal. Savannah got that one first. Moyers runs it down, and a foul here gives control back to Savannah. So Pritchett coming on for Solomon. The 68th minute of action, Savannah hanging on to a 1-0 lead despite Maryland's best efforts. Two balls have rolled into the net for Maryland. One was called back due to offside, and the other was called back due to what was signaled as a handball. Pritchett, a hard foul here. No card is going to be issued to him. His first challenge, and I think he said something to Chandler Vaughn as he walked away. Yeah, he's saying a few things. Brian Albert has lost control of this contest. I'm sorry, folks. This is not a good showing for him in front of the evaluators. There's been hard foul after hard foul, yellow card after yellow card, and the players are not getting the message. Chandler Vaughn spun down hard. Caleb Pritchett comes away with just a warning. Amazingly so. Burnett pokes it forward. Gonzalez out ahead. Fireman's got some space to run onto it. He makes a touch. Going for Abdou Yam. Yam looks like he might be able to get to the bouncing ball. De Leon pokes it away and out into touch for a throw-in. Deep into the offensive third now as Maryland moves into the 70th minute, trailing by one. Looks like we've got the on-screen graphic reset. Edge of the box comes in. Crichton makes a save. As a Savannah player has dropped to a knee. It looks like it's Daniel DeLeon. as he's gonna take a swig of water, and maybe something wrong with his eye as he splashed water straight into his face. Thankful that Jack Crichton has a bottle of water there, as Max Rugova, the goal scorer, gets some water from the bench and he's ready to rejoin play. Crichton is going to send everybody forward as play has resumed. Crichton rolls it forward into the handlebar, out ahead, deep into the offensive third. Rugova could not get the header. Gonzalez back down for Espinal. Espinal over for Yam. Pritchett is giving a signal. He looks like he's ready to go. Back for Espinal instead. Garwin inside. Could not connect with Malik Tom. Out for a throw-in for the Bobcats. Quickly taken by Feilerman. Richard Forca down for Feilerman. Feilerman breaks through two defenders. Some arm wrestling going on. Gets the ball for Gonzalez off of a bounce. Pritchett in an onside position. Cannot win the header away from De Leon and Green. Ball is going to roll forward here for Andres Sanchez. Savannah now looking to add to their advantage. Put two up against Maryland. Big save, Sutton. Strong wrists keeping that one close. No rebound chances this time around. Feilerman. Feilerman wings it well wide, looking for Malik Tom. Vaughn thought about cutting it off, instead played one-on-one defense. He'll lose this battle. Tom, back touch. Burnett. Abdou-Yam. Yam, Burnett making a run, back for Espinal. Espinal spins it toward goal, cannot get it for Pritchett. Espinal cuts through the defense. He sends a shot on and well high and wide. Uncharacteristic move from Espinal. He does have the most shots on the team, by a wide margin, by the way. So, not unusual for him to try a chance at goal. Just went well away from his intended target. Alex Cow is at the Maryland bench giving some instructions to number 16, Pierre Richard. So, potentially another sub coming on with offensive tendencies. Forca wins the header for the Bobcats. Down to Espinal. Yam finding Tom. Malik at the touchline. He's taken to the ball by two players. Chandler Vaughn is the last touch on it as Max Rugova gave a swing at Philip Burnett. And this is an ugly contest tonight. Nice spin move by Alex Sutton to keep the ball away from Benjamin Mackay. His pass goes well long of his intended target, and Savannah now has the chances here. Iridis cuts in, pass just away from the boots of his intended target. Poussaion still running hard here at 73 minutes in action. Poussaion now on the right-hand side of the offensive attack. Leaves it for Espinal. Yam has some space here. Malik Tom's got it in the space. Into the box. Tom puts one in. Header goes up and away. Intended target was Caleb Pritchett. Kept it low, and Savannah was able to defend that one. Yam wins the ball. Back heel, Malik Tom. Taken down inside the area. No foul. Chandler Vaughn getting away with one there, perhaps. As the ball does roll out of play for it looks to be a Bobcats corner kick. Manuel Gonzalez is going to be the one to take it. He puts his left hand up. Sends a ball in. Looking at the far post. Richard Forca sends it down. Couldn't find Malik Tom. Forca keeping it alive. Malik Tom cannot run this one down. Savannah has no numbers up, but they have the ball. Poussaion winning the ball cleanly with some hard play, taking it off of Andres Sanchez. Burnett. Espinal. Here again. Looking for Yam. Koye. Michael trying to find some kind of option. Darwin's got it in the penalty area. Spins out away from there. Darwin for Manny. Manny lines up a shot. Into the gloves of Crichton. Poked up and over the goal. Bobcats offense coming alive here in the last few minutes. And it sets up a corner kick. Pierre Richard looks like he's going to be the one to come on. They're going to wait till after this corner kick to make the substitution, though. Gonzalez had the most recent chance at goal. Crichton had to be big to make the save. Shot comes in. Well, long. Filerman plays it down to himself. Cannot get control. Iorides is going to harass him toward the touchline. Filerman taken down, keeping possession momentarily as we enter the 76th minute of time. Foul given here as Filerman was just trying. A yellow card's been issued too. Looks like Akinkoye has been given a yellow card for the foul that led to this play. And yeah, Akinkoye, yeah, you can't do that. Substitute is going to come on for the Bobcats, Pierre Richard. He's going to replace the aforementioned Akinkoye. So Richard on, Akinkoye off. As this brief stop and play gives me a chance to say congratulations to Mohamed Kanté and his family. They welcomed a son into the world on August 4th. Mohamed Kanté not available to play tonight, but from all of us here at the Bobcats, we're thankful that the baby is healthy and everybody is doing well so far from what we hear. We hope nothing but the best for the young man. Ball out of play and a throw in here for the Bobcats. As quickly this is turning into the last 15 minutes of action, and what seemed to be a runaway potential for a win for the Bobcats is turning into one of the biggest surprises of the weekend so far. Savannah's got the lead, but they have just been hanging on for dear life against this Maryland offense. Jack Crichton has had to be the team's best player as he's pushed multiple balls over the bar and into his gloves. And a little help from his goalposts has helped too, as Malik Tom had the best chance. Pritchett cannot run this one down. Abdou-Yam's got it. He forced Vaughn into a decision, and Vaughn concedes the corner with a header. Another right side of the offense attack here. They're going to try something different with Yam taking it. He takes it quickly into the box. Espinal bounced up into his face, puts it toward the goal, and Pritchett pushed it wide. It went off of a body, so the Bobcats will keep control on the corner kick. Yam faked the short chance, now puts both hands up. Bobcats will try a more controlled set piece to the back post. Cannot find Forca. Foul here as Forca was ruled to have dragged down a player in the process. If Maryland ends up the losers in this game, it is not for a lack of trying. Maryland does have three substitutes to make. They have one natural striker left on the bench in Carl Mbobo. Andrew Wivel frequently comes up into the striker spot as well. He is available tonight. Long ball here. Sutton doesn't have to do much for this one as he just watches his teammates as this bounces up. Forca cannot get this one away from Mackay. Sanchez runs it around and he'll just chip it well long. Poussaion runs it to the touchline and will get it for Sutton. Sutton has to make a quick move. Sends a pass for Espinal. Espinal gets it down to himself. He's got Yam and Tom in some space. Malik Tom gets the ball. Malik Tom on some run here into the middle. And Pritchett and Yam could not communicate who had that one. Crichton comes out and says, thank you very much. Jack Crichton has been the MVP of this contest. I don't care what any NISA poll says. Rogova sends this one deep, and Sutton had to track that one pretty well to see if he needed to make a jump at it, but it went over the bar. And now some urgency here as we enter the final 10 minutes of action. Maryland in danger of dropping points to the ninth place team in the league out of nine teams. Forca. Gonzalez. A deep ball here. Cannot get it to Tom. Chandler Vaughn is going to escort this one to the byline. Crichton will have another goal kick. Alex Cow, once again shouting out instructions from the bench area. Looks like another sub is going to get ready to come on. I believe that is Andrew Wivel getting set to go. A swing of the right leg sends this one long. Forka once again right into his forehead. It has been well used throughout today's contest. Sanchez for Moyers. Poked out of play by Malik Tom. Alex Cow is imploring Wivel, hurry up, get ready. We want you to go in now. He's got to wait a little bit. Nice play by Malik Tom to win the ball away from Andre Sanchez. It doesn't end up in possession, but that's a heady play from a young player in this league. Burnett boots this one high. Caleb Pritchett gets the header down for Abdou Yam. He'll send it into space for James Filerman. Filerman gets it before the touchline. Filerman waits. Options developing in the box. Filerman runs. Filerman retreats. Filerman loses the ball. Filerman cannot get control back. And now Savannah, potentially a 3-on-1 break here. Offside, though! Rugova ran early. And a break here for the Bobcats as they have a chance now to bring on Wivel. As Wivel is going to come on here, and he will replace Malik Tom. So an interesting move here for the third substitute of Alex Cow, as Wivel is going to come on, a natural midfielder, and replace Malik Tom, a natural striker. Man, Malik Tom had easily the best chance of the day for Maryland with that shot right off of the goalpost. He had time, he set up his strike, he got it past Crichton, and it just missed his intended spot. Wivel, moving with speed. Wivel, looking to create, has three Savannah Clovers around him, lost control of the ball. And yeah, I'm sorry, Benjamin Mackay, you are indeed offside. Burnett and the Bobcats look teaming up to get this one to the offside line. Manuel Gonzalez taking the free kick. Yam cannot find the ball on the bounce. Richard pokes it free. Abdou Yam once again. Yam into the box. Espinal, he's got a chance here. Espinal moves it forward. Poked off of a Savannah. Corner kick. Left side of the attack, Abdou is going to be the one to go over and grab this one. 83rd minute. Does Maryland have a late tie goal here in this contest? In swinging corner, into the area, and Richard got on top of it, but sent it wide. He didn't have a lot of room to get that one on net. It was offside anyway, so instead of a goal kick, it'll be inside the 6-yard box, but it's basically a goal kick as Crichton is going to send everybody up ahead, but it's not a traditional goal kick. I thank our cameraman Mo for picking up that it was offside. My view is a little bit obstructed by a stanchion here in the box that cuts off my view of the AR official on that side of the field at certain points, especially when they get inside of the 6-yard. Personally, I don't think offside should really matter inside the 6-yard box. You're already there. Oh, well, I'm not the one in charge of making the rules of the sport. Filerman, heavy first touch, gets on control of it. Pritchett looks like he's onside here. Offside, though! Caleb Pritchett's first goal is wiped out due to offside. I don't know if that was the correct call. The Federation evaluators need to take a look at this game tape and show it to every new official and say, this is not how you do your job. Oh, boy. This has been a bad night. Listen, I'll give referees credit when they deserve it. Tonight's crew does not. Rolled into the box. Rugova goes down. No penalty is going to be awarded here. I might have said some naughty words if a penalty was awarded there. Yam. Yam coming through into the box. He's surrounded by three players. Into Wivel! Just saved! Crichton comes out for the dive! Jack Crichton has had to be the best player on the field for Savannah. And he's keeping the Bobcats off the board all by his lonesome with his two hands. Man, Caleb Pritchett even made a last-second check on that run. I'm not sure how that was offside. I really don't think it was. Burnett, header, out of play. Chandler Vaughn is the one with the ball now. Vaughn swings it out ahead. Mackay cannot get control of the ball. Poussin's on it. Poussin finding Gonzalez. A foul is awarded somewhere before the pass. Gonzalez pokes it back for Sutton. And Maryland's got to try something here. They're down to 5.5 minutes of normal time left as our fourth official, Jose Zepeda Aguilera, is giving some words to Alex Cao as far as why Pritchett was offside on the play, perhaps. Throw in here for the Bobcats, taken quickly. Filerman breaking in, loses control, and it's out of play again for another throw, this time on the opposite end of the midfield line. 4 minutes to go. Richard sends a swinging pass for Poussin. Poussin's got space up the middle. He'll go, finding Burnett behind him. Burnett for Sutton. Sutton is well out. Alex Cao is imploring his team to pass the ball forward. They've got to get one to tie this game. Pass goes long for Filerman, and Alex Cao returns to his bench. Not happy with his troops this evening. Rugova. Max has it. Richard giving him some challenge, and now Forca takes away the ball. Richard gave it to Richard. Wivel's got a lot of space on this right side. He'll cut to the middle. Long pass. Filerman goes out and meets it. Filerman swings it to the box low and kicked out deep. Iarides was the one to kick it away. Richard keeping it in play. Final 3 minutes now, plus whatever our fourth official is going to add. Richard thought about the pass for Burnett, opted to go forward and find the shorter option for Poussin. Gonzalez, Wivel, along the near side, has some space up against Moyer's one-on-one. Espinal has some magic in those boots. Yam sends a pass on. It took a deflection. Corner kick gonna come here for Maryland. Deflection came off of Daniel De Leon in that center back two formation that they've been running, much like a foosball team. So a late corner here for Maryland. Do they have an equalizer? Two hands go up. Ball swings inward. Forca couldn't get on that one. Richard running it down. Getting it back for, looks to be Espinal. And it takes another deflection. Corner kick once more. Espinal's going to take it again on the left side of the offense. Heavy legs now for Maryland, entering the final 1.5 minutes of regular time. Richard looking to pull a couple of defenders away as he makes himself the short option. Two arms go quickly up into the middle of the area, punched out of there. Wivel comes down on it, pokes it three, and Crichton let it slide, but it's going to be a third corner kick in a row. Third corner kick in a row coming up for Maryland. Espinal swings this one in, going to the long option. Gonzalez rolls it through into the box. Forca could not get a foot on it. It'll roll out for a corner kick. Sorry about the technical difficulties that we're having up here in the booth. We're trying to get picture restored to you as fast as we can. Poussin, Richard, middle of the field, edge of the box. Richard moves to the right side. Filerman swings it on, and Crichton, that's an easy save for him. He'll fall on top of it as we enter the final 30 seconds of action. Looks like we've got picture back, so again, sorry to everybody that our, looked like our camera battery ran low, but we're plugged in, so that really shouldn't have happened, but we got it figured out. Crichton sends this one up, And it goes for Sutton. A late substitute looks like it's going to come on for Savannah at the next stop, as Alejandro Cruz is waiting in the fourth official's box. Hussain. Out ahead. Wivel. Out ahead. And, oh no, Richard got it. And we're finally into the 90th minute plus. We're trying to get picture restored to you. I'll go radio style for now. Out on the near side, out ahead of the box, and a substitute's going to be called on. Maryland cannot take this quickly. Alejandro Cruz is going to come on. That's the last substitute for Savannah, as it looks like Max Rogova, the penalty kick taker, is going to be the one to come off. Rogova has the one goal so far in this contest. I have not seen a signal for stoppage time just yet as we've entered into stoppage areas. There's been plenty of whistles in this second half, so probably a couple of minutes, maybe even four, as Cruz comes in to defend this throw-in. Burnett is the one that's going to come on to take it. Burnett sends this one deep. At the edge of the box, it's Pritchett. Leaves it for Gonzalez. Gonzalez puts us into the area up ahead. Forca gets ahead to it. It falls for Moyers, though. Kicked out into the midfield circle. Alex Sutton's got it. Sutton sends this one deep. Maryland has a couple players offside. Chandler Vaughn, header, out of play, near side. Taking a throw in quickly. As it looks like we've got picture restored for you. Gonzalez sends this one deep. Ahead, out away from Filerman. Espinal runs it down. Espinal swings it back into the box. Headed away. That was Michael Green. Midfield circle now. Hussain is the only one back for Maryland, as Benjamin Mackay is content to just run this one slowly out. Iarides. The Cypriot national had the only goal for Savannah in their last visit here, and one goal looks like it's going to be all they need. Far side throw in for Savannah, and I'm not really sure how much time has been added for stoppage time, if any. We're very much at the discretion of our match official. Hard shot, big save, Sutton, keeping it to 1-0. A foul is awarded, and Sutton is going to have a chance to line up an extended goal kick outside of his 6-yard box. He's going to have to take it quickly, as Maryland is running out of time. Hussain. Josylin, the captain, commanding his troops on the field. Implores Gonzalez to come forward for it. Gets it. Espinal out at the near side, right at the Bobcats bench. Gets it tossed right to him. Hussain sends a short pass. Richard gets it right to Manny Gonzalez. Gonzalez getting run down by Alejandro Cruz. Over to the far side of the field. Abdou Yam finding Filerman. Yam's going on a run. Yam to the byline. Yam gets it in, keeps the ball in play. Save made by Crichton. The rebound is loose. And Filerman's the one fortunate enough to grab it. Bounces off of a defender in front. And Savannah has possession. We're entering now the third minute of stoppage time that's been added. Sutton's going to come out of his crease to take the ball. Pass goes short. Benjamin Mackay can't get on the end of it, though. Full time as Sutton has the ball. Savannah breaks their losing streak at 8 and comes away with a 1-0 stunner. Savannah Clovers have come away with a 1-0 stunner here at Maryland Soccerplex as they walk away victorious off a penalty kick goal by their newest signing, Max Rogova. A tough break for Maryland. They had plenty of chances in this contest. 2 goals wiped off, one by offside, one by a handball, and Caleb Pritchett's last one was about as close as you get to not being offside. Wow. What a contest tonight here in NISA action. We thank you again for joining us and making us part of your Saturday night. Maryland Bobcats will be back in action here at the Soccerplex on August 19th, the Independent Cup Finals against the Maryland Bobcats Reserve Squad, followed by a trip to see Gold Star FC Detroit in the final game between those two sides. The next NISA action game here will be September 2nd in their final matchup against Flower City Union. Thank you for joining us, and as always, have a good night and a pleasant tomorrow.